Hello dear students, today we are going to start the third chapter of the class 10th and the topic is that is multi-purpose river projects and integrated water resource management. And in the yesterday we have discussed the main topic, that is the what is the water scarcity and some important facts related to the water we have discussed. And already we have discussed the diagram of the hydrological cycle, how the water move from evaporation process to condensation and then precipitation process. And already we have discussed what are the causes of the water scarcity problem and how we can resolve this problem through the management programs. All the points we have discussed related to the water scarcity problem. So today we are going to start with the next topic of the third chapter of geography, that is the water resource, and the topic is multi-purpose river project and the integrated water resource management. So first of all, dear students, all we know that during the as the history starts, different types of the developmental works was going on at that time, and related to the water conservation program, different types of the conservation program and the management program has been installed and has been adopted by the our historians and the peoples. So during those time in the ancient times, and we can get the records from the archaeological sites of our country where we found the historical records. So in the ancient times, people have constructing different types of the hydraulic structures like dams, and then reservoirs, lakes, ponds, embankment channels, and canals for the irrigation. So different types of the hydraulic structures has been created by the people in the ancient times. So some hydraulic structures in ancient India. So the first one, there is one village near Allahabad, that is the Sri Gavirapura, that is has the this Sri Gavirapura village near Allahabad has sophisticated water harvesting system, and that water harvesting system control the flood which was originated by the river Ganga. So this one is the first hydraulic structure in our country. Then second one, during the period of the Chandragupta Maurya, different types of the dams, lakes, irrigation system were extensively built by Chandragupta Maurya and his kingdom. Then again, some through the archaeological evidences, different types of the evidences has been found related to the irrigation works. Like one is Kalinga, and all we know that the Kalinga is the old name of the Odisha. Nagarjuna Konda, that is in Andhra Pradesh, Benur, that is in Karnataka, and Kolhapur, that is in the Maharashtra. So these types of the irrigational works has been found in the parts of our country. Then in the 11th century, Bhopal, which was earlier and now it this city is called as Bhopal, that is the city of lakes, and Bhopal is the capital of Madhya Pradesh. And different types of the artificial lakes has been built in during the ancient time. And then again, one important point that is related to the hydraulic structure, that is in the 14th century, the tank in Hauj Khas, that is in Delhi, was constructed by the Iltutmish. And Iltutmish, all we know that belongs to the slave dynasty, and that Hauj Khas Delhi tank supplying water to the Siri Fort area. So Siri Fort area ke liye Hauj Khas ka jo tank tha, wo water ki supply provide karta tha. So these are the hydraulic structure we have studied here. So here we have discussed the Chandragupta Maurya period, then 14th century Iltutmish period, and Bhopal lake, and then different types of the sophisticated irrigation works in Kalinga, Benur, Kolhapur, and then Nagarjuna Konda, that is in Andhra Pradesh. And already we have discussed the Allahabad sophisticated water harvesting canals. Then this one is the dam of the Hirakund dam, and all we know that Hirakund is the longest dam of the world, and Hirakund is over the Mahanadi river. Kaun si nadi ke upar hai? Mahanadi river. GK ka important question hai, Mahanadi river. Aur ye Hirakund aur Mahanadi river kahan pe hai? That is in the Odisha, in the Indian state jiska naam hai Odisha mein ye Hirakund dam jo hai Mahanadi river ke upar. Uske baad ab why these hydraulic structure has been created, so why they have been built, because of conserving and managing water. So two main agenda behind the hydraulic structures in our country, that is first one conservation point of view and second one is management of water. Clear? तो दीज टू पॉइंट्स, फर्स्ट वन कंजर्वेशन, सेकंड वन इज द मैनेजमेंट ऑफ द वाटर. दीज हाइड्रोलिक स्ट्रक्चर हैड बीन क्रिएटेड एंड देन ट्रेडिशनली डैम्स वर बिल्ट टू इम्पाउंड रिवर्स. तो मल्टीपर्पज़ रिवर प्रोजेक्ट्स से पहले क्या थे, डैम्स थे जो इंडिया में बिल्ट किए गए थे ओवर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ द रिवर. एंड फॉर वन एग्जाम्पल दैट इज़ द भाखड़ा नंगल डैम, भाखड़ा नंगल डैम. और भाखड़ा नंगल डैम कौन सी रिवर में है, दैट इज़ इन दैट इज़ ओवर द सतलुज रिवर. एंड दिस रिवर दैट इज़ इन द भाखड़ा इज़ इन द हिमाचल एंड नंगल इज़ इन द पंजाब. सो दिस इज़ द भाखड़ा नंगल डैम ओवर द सतलुज रिवर. सो ट्रेडिशनली पहले क्या होते थे, डैम्स हुआ करते थे, बट अब मॉडर्न टाइम पीरियड के साथ क्या स्टार्ट हो गया, मल्टीपर्पज़ रिवर प्रोजेक्ट. एंड दीज डैम्स आर बिल्ट नॉट जस्ट फॉर इरीगेशन बट फॉर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी जनरेशन. क्या मेजर पॉइंट है डैम्स से रिलेटेड, डैम वाई द डैम्स हैज़ बीन क्रिएटेड, दैट दे हैज़ बीन बिल्ट ओनली फॉर द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी जनरेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू एंड नॉट फॉर द इरीगेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. क्लियर. एंड देन अगेन फॉर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी जनरेशन के लिए, वाटर सप्लाई के लिए, डोमेस्टिक एंड इंडस्ट्रियल यूजेस के लिए, फ्लड कंट्रोल के लिए, रिक्रिएशनल एंड नेविगेशन, फिश ब्रीडिंग. सो दीज आर द यूजेस ऑफ द डैम्स. हैंस डैम्स नाउ रेफर्ड टू एज मल्टीपर्पज़ रिवर प्रोजेक्ट. अब जितने भी डैम्स हैं इनको अब क्या रेफर किया बोल रहे हैं, क्या इनके लिए प्रोनाउंस किया जा रही है, एक मेजर टर्म यूज़ की जा रही है, दैट इज़ मल्टीपर्पज़ रिवर प्रोजेक्ट या मल्टीपर्पज़ प्रोजेक्ट. वेयर नाउ द क्वेश्चन अराइजेज, व्हाट इज़ द मल्टीपर्पज़ प्रोजेक्ट. सो इन द मल्टीपर्पज़ प्रोजेक्ट फेयर मैनी यूजेज ऑफ द इम्पाउंडेड वाटर आर इंटेग्रेटेड विद वन अनदर. फॉर एग्जाम्पल वैन वी क्रिएट विल्ट एनी टाइप ऑफ मल्टीपर्पज़ रिवर प्रोजेक्ट. सो फर्स्ट वन वाई द मल्टीपर्पज़ रिवर प्रोजेक्ट हैज़ बीन विल्ट, बिकॉज ऑफ कंट्रोल ऑफ फ्लड्स, प्रोवाइडिंग वाटर फॉर द इरीगेशन पर्पज, प्रोवाइडिंग वाटर फॉर द इंडस्ट्री पर्पज, प्रोवाइडिंग वाटर फॉर द हाउस होल्ड एंड एग्रीकल्चरल पर्पज, एंड अगेन फॉर रिक्रिएशनल फैसिलिटीज, टूरिज्म, फॉर डेवलपिंग द टूरिज्म एंड जनरेटिंग द हाइड्रो इलेक्ट्रिसिटी एंड अदर एंड प्रोवाइडिंग फॉर एनरिचिंग द फ्लोरा एंड फौना. सो दीज आर कॉल्ड एज द मल्टीपर्पज़ रिवर प्रोजेक्ट. मीन्स फॉर एग्जाम्पल वाटर इज ओनली फॉर द जनरेटिंग हाइड्रो इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, सो देर इज ओनली वन एजेंडा द डैम्स आर मीटिंग, बट मल्टीपर्पज़ रिवर प्रोजेक्ट आर मीटिंग विद अ नंबर ऑफ पर्पसेज. दैट्स वाई दीज आर कॉल्ड एज द मल्टीपर्पज़ रिवर प्रोजेक्ट्स. एंड हेयर एग्जाम्पल, फॉर एग्जाम्पल भाखड़ा ब्यास रिवर बेसिन, द भाखड़ा नंगल प्रोजेक्ट इज बींग यूज बोथ हाइड्रल पावर प्रोडक्शन एंड इरीगेशन पर्पज. सिमिलरली हीराकुंड प्रोजेक्ट, हीराकुंड डैम, ऑलरेडी आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट दिस वन इज द लॉन्गेस्ट डैम ऑफ द वर्ल्ड एंड ओवर द महानदी रिवर एंड इज इन द ओडिशा स्टेट. तो अगेन दिस इज फॉर द कंजर्वेशन ऑफ वाटर विद फ्लड कंट्रोल. नाउ कम टू दैट पॉइंट, वट इज द डैम. सो डैम इज अ बैरियर अक्रॉस द रिवर और अक्रॉस फ्लोइंग वाटर दैट ऑब्स्ट्रक्ट, डायरेक्ट्स एंड रिटार्ड्स द फ्लो, ऑफन क्रिएटिंग अ रेजरवायर. डैम्स को हम रेजरवायर भी बोल सकते हैं, लेक, एक तरह की लेक भी होगी एंड इम्पाउंडमेंट्स भी हो गया. तो क्या कर रहा है ये, अक्रॉस द फ्लोइंग वाटर दैट ऑब्स्ट्रक्ट, डायरेक्ट्स एंड रिटार्ड्स द फ्लो ऑफ वाटर. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड एज द डैम्स. नाउ कम टू द पॉइंट, वॉट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन डैम एंड मल्टीपर्पज रिवर प्रोजेक्ट. Yes, now we are going to discuss a very important question related to this chapter. What is the concept of dam and multipurpose river project? So dam is a barrier across the flowing water, means river, that obstruct, dissect, retards the flow of water and creating a reservoir, lake and impoundments. So that is called as the dam is a barrier across the flowing of water and creating a reservoir, lake and impoundment, and it is a traditional concept. Now what is the multipurpose project? A multipurpose project is that which fulfills a variety of purpose, means a multiple of purpose are there at the same time. For example, irrigation will be there, generation of electricity, flood control, fish breeding, soil conservation, providing water for the household, industries, agriculture, etc., and it is a modern concept. So this is the difference between dam and multipurpose river project. So after the dam and multipurpose river project, so multipurpose river project launched after the independence, when India got the independence from the Britishers. So with the integrated water resource management approach, कौन सी approach use की हमने, very important point है, resource management approach के under we have built the multipurpose project after the independence. And these are also called as the vehicle that is mainly responding the development and progress. So इनको क्या बोला जाता है, vehicle of development and progress, that is the multipurpose river project. And जवाहरलाल नेहरू proudly proclaimed that during the भाखड़ा नंगल डैम the Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru proclaimed, the dams are the temples of modern India. Very important line I am going to underline here, that dams are called as the temples of modern India. Why? Because they are providing us water for irrigation, water for agriculture, water for household industry, controlling the floods, for recreational facilities, fish breeding, and developing the tourism, and providing hydroelectricity. So these are the important points related to the dams are the temples of modern India. And in this point, we have to again discuss the merits of the dams or merits of the multi-purpose river project. So this is the, and again these and dams again is very helpful in the development of agriculture as well as the industrialization and urban growth of the urban economy. So this is the importance of the dam. Then after the this importance of the dam, different types of the these dams have the different types of the negative points. So again, multi-purpose project dam has the positive point and the negative point. So first of all, we have to see the which are the positive and the negative point of the dams. So first one, advantages means merits of multi-purpose river project. So first one, it controls floods, providing irrigation facility and navigation facilities, again very helpful to for the generation of electricity. It promote inland irrigation, comma fishing and afforestation. Three important points covered by this point. It promotes inland irrigation, fishing and afforestation for human consumption, and it also provide power generation and providing the water for the industries, agriculture and household. And also multi-purpose project, the water that is comes in the category of the reserved resource, which we have discussed in the chapter number one, resource. Then what are the disadvantages? So first one, it induce earthquake. So dams are responsible for the origin of the earthquake. Population can gets displaced, means when we are constructing the dam over a particular area, so the nearby the area which population is residing there, so there is displacement of the people. That is major negative point. Aquatic life get affected. Aquatic life mean marine life, the life which lives in the water area, under the water area, like fish and other types of the organism and flora and fauna, so that get affected. And mainly the fishing, that is fishes biodiversity has been affected. Then flow of underground water is also checked. I mean there is a negative impact produced by the multi-purpose river project over the underground water. Then rainwater gets diverted. So rainwater bhi kya hoga? Gets diverted hoga. Flood again with the high rainfall, and the water of the reservoir has comes out, so there is again problem of the floods is there. Extensive forest area submerged under the water. If we are talking about the Bhakranangal dam or other types of the dam, so near about most of the area get converted under the water area. So these are the negative point. Again, next slide we can see what are the multi-purpose project. So the project is a large scale for hydro project, including dams for water retention, canal for irrigations, water processing and pipelines to supply water to cities and power generation. And these often include transportation improvements, industrial growth and also reduce danger of flooding. So control the flood, positive point kya hai? Eliminates of reduce flooding, mean control on floods, impounds water for later use as the for the irrigation purpose, human consumption, industry consumption, lake fisheries, development of fisheries is there, power generation, transportation and recreation purpose. Then negative points, displacement of the people, destroy prime agricultural land, very important point, destroy agricultural land, destroy riverine ecological habitat, means the land habitat of the organism, that is again destroyed by the multi-purpose river project, destroy historic and archaeological sites, may damage downstream ecologies and including estuary fisheries, disturbed existing infrastructure, can increase the needs of fertilizer and thus increasing the incidence of water pollution will be there, deforestation, is enhance the deforestation. So these are the positive and negative point of the multi-purpose river. So in this whole over page, the positive and negative point have been discussed here. And one important point here regarding the displacement of the people, so there is one example, that is the Narmada Bachao Andolan. So there in the history, when Sardar Sarovar Dam has been created over the Narmada River in Gujarat, so there is one movement that rises from that state, that is the Narmada Bachao Andolan. And again related to Uttarakhand region, Tehri Dam, which is the highest dam of India, that is the Tehri Dam. So this is again Tehri Dam Andolan. So different types of the Andolan and movement has been launched by the people regarding the displacement of the people and destroy of their prime agricultural land. So there is one very important story regarding the Sardar Sarovar Dam, which is built over the Narmada River in Gujarat. So why that project, why that Andolan has been in famous during that time? So this project, India's this project Sardar Sarovar Dam covering four major states, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat and Rajasthan. And Sardar Sarovar project would meet the requirement of water in drought prone area. So this is for the drought region of our country, that is the desert region, and providing 9490 villages and 173 towns. And in Rajasthan, 124 village, mean itne logon ke liye, itne villages ke liye, it will be helpful. Then why the project has been in very was very famous during that time? So this is the PDF file of the Sardar Sarovar Dam. So Sardar Sarovar Dam is a gravity dam, means gravity dam means which is constructed with the help of the concrete cement. So that is called as the gravity dam over the on the river Narmada, and that is in near Nawagam in Gujarat. तो कौन सी स्टेट में है? गुजरात में है ये. और कौन सी रिवर के ऊपर है? नर्मदा रिवर के ऊपर. और ग्रेविटी डैम है, और कौन सा डैम है? सरदार सरोवर डैम. फोर स्टेट्स को ये कवर करता है, गुजरात, मध्य प्रदेश, महाराष्ट्र, राजस्थान. एंड रिसीव वाटर एंड इलेक्ट्रिसिटी सप्लाइड फ्रॉम द डैम. एंड द फाउंडेशन स्टोन ऑफ दिस प्रोजेक्ट वॉज लेड आउट बाई आर फर्स्ट प्राइम मिनिस्टर, दैट इज पंडित जवाहरलाल नेहरू, ऑन 5th अप्रैल 1961. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट डेट, सो यू कैन राइट 5th अप्रैल 1961. एंड दिस प्रोजेक्ट टुक फॉर्म इन 1971 एज अ डेवलपमेंटल स्कीम फंडेड बाई द वर्ल्ड बैंक. तो इसका जो फर्स्ट इसका प्रोजेक्ट का फाउंडेशन स्टोन रखा वो पंडित जवाहरलाल नेहरू ने कब? 5th अप्रैल 1961. और इसको वर्ल्ड बैंक ने फंडिंग स्टार्ट की 1979 ने थ्रू द IBRD. IBRD ही वर्ल्ड बैंक की एक ब्रांच है जिसका नाम है इंटरनेशनल बैंक फॉर रिकंस्ट्रक्शन एंड डेवलपमेंट, टू इंक्रीज इरीगेशन एंड प्रोड्यूस हाइड्रो इलेक्ट्रिसिटी यूजिंग अ लोन. कितना लोन दिया था? $200 मिलियन. बट द प्रोजेक्ट द कंस्ट्रक्शन फॉर द डैम बिगन इन 1987. 1987 में इसकी कंस्ट्रक्शन स्टार्ट हुई, जबकि इसका फाउंडेशन स्टोन 1961 में रखा. फिर ये प्रोजेक्ट जो है सुप्रीम कोर्ट ऑफ इंडिया, दैट इज इन 1995, बैकड्रॉप इन नर्मदा बचाओ आंदोलन. फिर इसको 1995 में सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने इसको क्या किया? बैकड्रॉप में रखा, किस मूवमेंट के अंदर? नर्मदा बचाओ आंदोलन के अंदर. और उस तरह से ये डैम जो है अभी रिसेंटली 2017 में सुप्रीम कोर्ट की गाइडलाइंस के अंदर जो ये डैम 2017 में ही कंप्लीट हुआ. एंड दैट इज़ इन द सरदार सरोवर डैम इज़ एट केवड़िया डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ द केवड़िया विलेज, दैट इज़ इन द डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ नर्मदा इज़ इन गुजरात. एंड रीच इट्स हाइस्ट कैपेसिटी 138.68 मीटर क्लियर. एंड 15 सितंबर 2019 का ये डाटा है. तो ये 2017 में हमारे प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी जी के द्वारा इसका क्या किया गया, इसको स्टार्ट किया गया था इस डैम को. तो कहाँ क्या है इसका नाम? ऑफिशियल नेम है नर्मदा वैली. कंट्री इंडिया है. कहाँ पे है? नावागाम केवड़िया, दैट इज़ इन गुजरात रीजन. और कंस्ट्रक्शन बिगन हुई थी 1987 में, और ओपनिंग डेट इसकी हुई 17 सितंबर 2017 में. कंस्ट्रक्शन कॉस्ट कितनी आई है? ₹25 बिलियन इंडियन नेशनल रुपी क्लियर. ग्रेविटी डैम है, नर्मदा रिवर के ऊपर है. हाइट कितनी है? 138.68 मीटर है क्लियर. लेंथ इसकी है 1210 मीटर इसकी लेंथ है. सो दिस इज़ द फ्यू डाटाज रिलेटेड टू द सरदार सरोवर डैम. So this is the whole information regarding the Sardar Sarovar Dam, which is built over the Narmada River in Gujarat, and then major dams. So we will do a separate lecture. In that lecture, we will do the major dams, which is suggested by the CBSE. Clear? So this is whole information related to this chapter, that is the this topic, multipurpose river project, and then mainly demerits and merits have been discussed here. So this is enough for this topic, and for tomorrow, we will start with the topic rainwater harvesting and its technique. Thank you.